Select BF Goodrich, Goodyear, General, or Uniroyal tires with a premium installation package and wheel alignment and save $100. First Turn Automotive, a proud sponsor of Fort Bend Vite Sports. Make your appointment today at any of the four convenient locations in Sugarland and Cinco Ranch. All four stores open on Saturday. FirstTireAndAuto.com.
You are the master of the multitask, the champion of making it happen. Taking care of business is not for the faint of heart. Still, you take care of it.
Taking care of business.
But who takes care of you? Office Depot Office Max. We supply you, copy you, and tune you up. Members get 2% back in rewards on everything, and we mean everything. We take care of you, so you can take care of business. Office Depot Office Max.
Taking care of business.
About to talk, you know, you don't want to interrupt Pat Benatar any more than you want to interrupt Billy Idol, but then they restarted the music. But we'll soon be going to the bottom of the second. You're listening to VibeFortBend.com, your broadcast home for Fort Bend County Sports.
Now batting, leading off the bottom of the second for Ridgepoint, the second baseman, number six, Zach Ellis.
Alright, for those of you who lost the signal, we are back online, tells me our producer Suna Venkat. Now Zach Ellis, by the way, it was Zach's dad who let me know that we had a Wi-Fi connectivity problem, but we think we have it under control. So the right-handed hitting Ellis with a slightly closed stance, looks at the first pitch from Golden, swings and misses at the curveball. And Golden really took something off of that one. It was kind of like a Zach Greinke curveball. And it's nothing in one. He winds and brings the next one. Swung on and missed. That one dropped off the table. He didn't quite spike it, but the splitter was effective. Now Golden rocks and brings the next one. Here's a chopper toward third, but it goes foul before it reaches Tyler Doe. It's not quite as windy as it was at Travis last night when on their senior night they clinched the outright District 26A title. Golden ready, and here's the pitch. Ellis swings, and there's a hard ground ball to Doe. He releases it quickly, gets it over to Sherman, and that's out number one.
Now batting the third baseman, number 24, Quinn Pfeiffer.
Now Quinn Pfeiffer, the third baseman. The mighty Quinn batting with one out and the base is empty here in the bottom of the second. No score between Austin and Ridgepoint. First pitch outside. DeSega tried to frame it, didn't get the call. Golden brings the next one. Breaking ball right down the middle. And it's 1-1. The last two games we've done, the Dulles Travis game on Monday night and the Travis Elkins game last night, both went over 3 hours. And Pfeiffer with a tapper to Doe. Charges and fires. Gets his man again.
Now batting. Carter Groen.
Now Carter Groen, whose dad Clary Groen is the PA man here at Ridgepoint. Right-handed hitter wants to make sure those white gloves are on tight. Golden has been ready to pitch for several seconds now. Brings it. Spikes the breaking ball. No chase on Groen's part, and it's 1-0. Ridgepoint's bats Had it easy last night, winning 13-0 over Bush. Here's a pitch on the outside corner at the knees. Called strike. And it's 1-1. So you could say Ridge Point's offense has been mercurial. There's a strike at the letters. That 12-6 break down into the strike zone, and that makes it 1-2. Golden works quickly. That one is chopped toward third. Here comes Doe again. Charges but can't scoop it with the bare hand. I don't think he was going to throw out Groen anyway. The ball didn't even make it halfway to third. It bounced high off that hard dirt in front of home plate.
Now
and it just
designated hitter, number 10, Colin Daigue.
Just didn't roll very far. Colin Daigue is the DH tonight. Two outs and the base is empty for him. No, I'm sorry. Two outs and Groen at first for him. Checks on the first pitch, which is high. Colin Daigue had been used as a pitcher a few times during the pre-district tournament stuff. Here's the 1-0. Swung on and missed. A changeup from Golden. He really pulled the string there. Over his left elbow, which he has, you know, the upper part of the arm parallel to the ground, gets the sign. Now he comes set at the belt, brings it. Daigue sends it in the air, foul on the right side, and it'll blow out of play. One and two, the count on Daigue. Golden steps over to the back of the mound. Now he's ready to pitch again. Groen takes his lead off of first. Here's the pitch. Breaking ball away. DeSiga blocks it. Did an excellent job keeping Groen from advancing to second. Thank you, producer Suna Venkat. Good feedback. Our signal is good. The wind is still a problem, but there's nothing we can do about that. And there is a pickoff of Groen. Golden with the quick move, and Colin Daigue is left standing in the batter's box. He'll lead off the next time Ridge Point bats. No score through two. We'll be back on VipeFortBend.com.
First Tire and Automotive will shower you in savings in April. Make sure you're not caught saying the wrong S word when it starts raining because you can't see out of your windshield. Safety first to get you to and from the big game. Check out these great savings. Wiper blades, buy one, get one free. Buy one, get one free on select contour beam windshield wipers. Purchase four select BF Goodrich, Goodyear, General, or Uniroyal tires with a premium installation package and wheel alignment and save $100. First Tire and Automotive, a proud sponsor of Fort Bend Vipe Sports. Make your appointment today at any of the four convenient locations in Sugarland and Cinco Ranch. All four stores open on Saturday. FirstTireAndAuto.com.
You are the master of the multitask, the champion of making it happen. Taking care of business is not for the faint of heart. Still, you take care of it.
Taking care of business.
But who takes care of you? Office Depot Office Max. We supply you, copy you, and tune you up. Members get 2% back in rewards on everything, and we mean everything. We take care of you so you can take care of business. Office Depot Office Max.
Taking care of business.
Now batting in the top of the third for Austin, the first baseman, number 23, Mark Sherman.
Mark Sherman stands in for the Austin Bulldogs, who are wearing the black jersey tops and the white pants with the pinstripes. First pitch swinging, and it's a foul tip off of the mitt of the catcher, Nelson. Sherman has scored 11 runs this year, driven in 12. He's got four doubles. Those are his extra base hits. Dasher brings the curveball. Check swing Sherman. No, he didn't check it. He went around, according to the home plate umpire. He made that call. He did not need to ask for help. That pitch is spiked and Sherman lays off. 1-2. Here's the next one from Dasher. Hard ground ball to third base. We've had a lot of those. Pfeiffer picks it clean, fires across, the throw's a bit high, but Rowan reels it in and there's one away. Now to the top of the order, and we'll see Ryan Branch.
For Austin, number 24, the center fielder, Ryan Branch.
Branch led off the game with what he thought was going to be a double, but he got himself thrown out at second. Curveball swung on and missed. Here's the 0-1 from Dasher. That's outside. You know, last night at Travis, there was no way anyone was going to hit a home run. The night before at Dulles, there were two bombs, and the wind was blowing out all night. Here's the 1-1, breaking ball down, 2-1. And when we were at Dulles on Saturday, when the Bulldogs beat the Vikings, the wind was also blowing in on that occasion, as well as Friday night when Ridge Point beat Elkins right here in Siena. Here's a pitch outside, and the count goes to 2-1. Make it 3-1. Dasher taking his time. Here's the pitch. Outside, and it's a ball 4 to Ryan Branch. So Branch has reached base twice. But this time he's going to stay on base while Naquan Benjamin bats. Benjamin 0-for-1 with a first inning strikeout. Dasher looks over there at Branch, throws over. Almost got him leaning. At Ridge Point, the dimensions are symmetrical, 315 feet down each line, 345 to the power alleys, and 370 to straightaway center. Benjamin takes, and it's in the dirt for a ball. Dasher looks over at first. Here's the pitch. And it's a bunt attempt, but it goes foul. And Benjamin kind of shaking his right hand as he picks the bat up again. In, stands tall in the right-handed box. Dasher looks at Branch, throws over there again, safely back in. Ridge Point will host Travis Friday and host Dulles on Saturday. There's a pitch. Ball 2-1. Pitch to Benjamin, and it's a slow roller toward second. Charging as Ellis makes the tag, and then on to first for the double play. Heady play by Zach Ellis at second base. That'll do it for these Austin Bulldogs in their half of the third, and we'll return on Vibe Fort Bend. Still no score. Okay, I'll try it. Let me see if this will work. Hold on a second.
Fast Wi-Fi. You use it to connect just about everything, which means having really fast Wi-Fi matters. A lot. That's why Xfinity is breaking the gig barrier and introducing Wi-Fi speeds faster than a gig. That's a big deal. It's a big deal for streaming big games, having big meetings, and making big plans. It's a big deal for families with one kid, or two kids, or three kids. Especially if there's one kid who has enough devices for 10 kids. It's a big deal for gamers who are streaming while someone else is posting about their virtual spin class. And yet, it's also a big deal for a quiet Friday night in. So get in on Wi-Fi speeds faster than a gig. That's more than enough speed to power every device in the house. Can your internet do that? Introducing gig speeds over Wi-Fi. It's the fastest Wi-Fi you can get, and it's only from Xfinity. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit an Xfinity store to learn more. Restrictions apply. Actual speeds vary and are not guaranteed.
Now batting the bottom of the third for Rich Point, the designated hitter, number 10, Colin Day.
During the commercial break, I met somebody. I didn't realize she was married to someone famous. I met Jenny Welch, the wife of the head coach for Rich Point, and Colin Day, first pitch swinging, drops a base hit at a short right center. Colin Day, who doesn't get that many offensive reps, is someone that gets into the lineup and want to see if he can get something going, and he reaches on his...
Number five, Owen Ferris.
I'm going to say he reaches in his first at bat, but not his first plate appearance, because he was in the batter's box when
Your attention, please, for Rich Point. Courtesy runner number three, Tyler Martin.
When Carter Groen was picked off, Daig was standing in the batter's box, so he leads off the third with a single. Don't have too much information. See, I get information about these players and coaches, but not coaches' wives. I heard that Jenny's number before Coach Welch married her was 8675309. Is that correct? Yeah. I don't know. You know, back then you didn't need area codes. Now there's a throw over, and it's Tyler Martin running for Daig. He gets back into first. And what Coach Welch's wife did for me is she took one of those things that you wrap up a folding chair in, and she tied it around the fence, so I have a little thing to help my umbrella block the wind without me having to hold it. So I'm now a two-armed man. I feel liberated. Here's a bunt attempt in the air, and DeSigo with a great effort, but he couldn't run it down. So Harrison Golden off the mound to make sure DeSigo's okay. And I think he's just fine. Wow, Eros DeSiga has a lot of hair under that catcher's helmet. Ferris looks over at Coach Welch in the third base box. We are scoreless in the bottom of the third, Rich Point and Austin. And Golden makes another throw over, and Martin dives back in. Golden comes set. Ferris already squared around a bunt. Here it comes, and he bunts it down the first base line, but it slices into foul territory, and Sherman picks it up. Nothing and two. So we'll see if Ferris swings away, or would Coach Welch dare to have him try and bunt with two strikes? Here's the pitch. Curveball missed. Nobody out as Rich Point bats in the bottom of the third. Scoreless game. Ferris ready. Swings. It's a weak swing. It's to Doe at third, and he goes to second. Not in time for the force. Everybody's safe. It was weakly hit, and it was really one of those no man's land kind of plays. No thought about it.
Back to the top of the lineup for Ridgepoint. Now batting the shortstop, Justin Vasos.
So back to the top, Justin Vasos hit a pop-up to first base in inning number one. And he'll try to get Ridgepoint back on top, or on top. First pitch to him, down and in for a ball. Bit of a jam. Pitch to Vasos. Takes a strike on the outside corner at the belt. Looks like maybe Justin thought it was outside. The 1-1 on the way. Curveball, and it just broke at the last instant and didn't hit Justin. Two runners on. Tyler Martin running off second and Owen Ferris at first. Boss is ready and takes a ball outside. You just took a flash picture, didn't you? Well, that's good. I just want to make sure it wasn't lightning. Just a flash, but not one that will bother the players. A conscientious baseball mom, Anna Catherine Rosa. Now Vasa swings and sends it in the air foul. Sherman gives it a look, but is flying out of play. Vasos with the low, slow practice swings. It's a full count now. Here's the payoff pitch. Outside for ball four, and the bases are loaded. So the inning starts with Day getting the base hit. Ferris hits the grounder to third, and Doe throws to second, but not in time. So now you have Tyler Martin at third, Ferris at second, Vasos at first.
Point the left fielder. Kyle Rosa.
Rosa hit by a pitch his first time. Golden from the stretch with the bases loaded. Nobody out. Brings it. Curveball upstairs. Get you an update on the softball game as soon as we get a chance. Golden brings it. That's outside in the count two and nothing. And there's no place to put Kyle Rosa. Rosa gets back in the box. Brings the 2-0. That's a strike on the outside corner at the belt. Fastball from Golden. Here's the 2-1 pitch. That's outside, 3-1. Ridgepoint has a pretty firm grip on the second seed in District 26A, but if they can get the win tonight, they'd be in really good shape, and Austin might fall back into a virtual tie with Dulles with less than a week to go. There's a ground ball through the right side. Rosa with an RBI single. Martin scores, and Ferris held at third base. The throw gets away from DeSiga now. Here comes Ferris. They throw to the plate. Not in time. Two runs have scored. Ferris gets filthy, and the Panthers lead it 2-0. And now Vasos is coming home, but wait a minute. No, time, I believe, had been called. That really got the Ridgepoint fans excited, though. Still nobody out. Vasos is at third. Rosa.
Center fielder, number 11, Garrett.
Rosa took second on all that commotion. And now it's Garrett Johnson. Johnson ready for the first one. Golden brings it. That's a ground ball to second. It gets past Watts. Vasa scores. And here comes Rosa. The throw is a little bit offline, and Rosa also scores. And suddenly, it is 4-0, Ridgepoint. That's going to be an E4. Watts needed to stay in front of it. And it just took a big hop right before it got to his glove.
Brandon Nelson.
But it's not what I'd call a bad hop. Golden now comes set at the belt, brings it. And the pitch is underneath the catcher, DeSiga. That'll be a wild pitch, and it enables a runner to get from first to second and now second to third as the throw gets away. Garrett Johnson, by the way, started to run off of second. His helmet came off. He caught it while running. He put it back on while still running. He's at third base, and he wants a new helmet. I don't know if there's some greasy kid stuff in there or what, but time is called, and we have a conference at the mound. It is Ryan Botchok, the assistant coach for Austin. So everything was going pretty well for these Bulldogs. But you have Johnson advanced to second on a wild pitch and then on a throwing error. He then advances to third. Nelson is in the box with a count of 1-0, and Golden is going to stay in there and keep pitching. Dogs sense that it is slipping away early. They don't want this to be one of those boat race games. As Ridgepoint has put 4 on the board. Nelson line to left field his first time. There's a high fly ball to center chasing Branch back. He's under it, makes the catch, but this will be a sacrifice fly. Coming on home is Garrett Johnson. And Ridgepoint is on top 5-0.
Now coming to the plate, the second baseman, Zach Ellis.
Now the bases are empty and finally an out. And Zach Ellis comes up 0-1 with a ground ball to third base. Looks at a curve and it's in there for a strike. Golden brings the next one. Another breaking ball out of the zone, and Zach chased it. Nothing in two. Golden rocks and fires off the end of the bat. High fly to right field, going back and making the catch is Dugas. Two away, and the base is still empty.
Quinn Pfeiffer.
Quinn Pfeiffer comes up 0-1. He grounded out to third just like Ellis in his first appearance at the plate. Looks at a curve down and away. 1-0. Golden brings the next one. Fastball, but it's down. The pitch. That's on the outside corner for a strike. 2-1. By the way, George Ranch is leading Dulles in the fourth inning. George Ranch, 2-0 over the Vikings, who are saying mayday, mayday. They have so many games to play this week, and it's just turned into a real struggle for them. Here's the pitch, and fouled back by Quinn Pfeiffer. The count now 3-2. By the way, in the fifth inning, the softball game is not going the Panthers' way. Tompkins leads it 10-4. Breaking ball, and Pfeiffer fights it off, gets just a little piece of it, and fouls it where it trickles right behind the home plate dirt. Outs. Golden delivers. Pfeiffer hits it in the air foul, and it'll go a long way in that wind. Golden nods at his catcher DeSiga, brings another 3-2, and that's outside. Ball four. Ridgepoint still has something going in the bottom of the third. They've already scored 5 runs.
Now batting the first baseman, Carter Groen.
So here's Carter Groen again. And he steps out before the first pitch from Golden. Groen singled in the second. He's 1-for-1. There was a throw over, and Pfeiffer got back, swung on and missed it to change up. Golden really makes his change up wind up look a lot, or I should say his change up delivery look like his fastball delivery, and that is half the battle right there. Quick move, throw over to first again, and Pfeiffer dives back. Ridgepoint has pushed 5 runs across the plate here in the bottom of inning number 3. Here's the next pitch, and it's outside. DeSiga moves to his right like a goalie and covers up what I guess would be the 4 hole. If he moves to his right, but, you know. And there's another throw over, and that one was kind of close, but Pfeiffer is safe. Point leads 5-0, even though they have only out-hit the Dogs 3-2. There's a foul ball that almost broke my umbrella. But I have another one. Here's a 1-2. It's outside for a ball, and Pfeiffer steals second without a throw. Tailor-made situation here. The right-handed swinging Groen looks at a curve in the dirt, lays off, and it's 3-2. Brings the next one. Groen takes, and there's the throw to third on an attempted steal, and Pfeiffer is gunned down. DeSiga showing a great arm, and I don't think Pfeiffer really got a very good jump there. That will end the inning, and we'll be back on VipeFortBend.com.
First Tire and Automotive will shower you in savings in April. Make sure you're not caught saying the wrong S word when it starts raining because you can't see out of your windshield. Safety first to get you to and from the big game. Check out these great savings. Wiper blades, buy one, get one free. Buy one, get one free on select contour beam windshield wipers. Purchase 4 select BF Goodrich, Goodyear, General, or Uniroyal tires with a premium installation package and wheel alignment and save $100. First Tire and Automotive, a proud sponsor of Fort Bend Vipe Sports. Make your appointment today at any of the 4 convenient locations in Sugarland and Cinco Ranch. All 4 stores open on Saturday. FirstTireAndAuto.com.
Are you ready?
Ready for anything. For what life throws at you? At your kids.
Are they ready to study, research, write papers?
To do all the amazing things they don't even know they're capable of yet.
Internet Essentials from Comcast brings affordable, high-speed internet to your home for only $9.95 a month. Now available to low-income households eligible for public assistance programs like Medicaid, the National School Lunch Program, SNAP, housing assistance, and others. Visit InternetEssentials.com to apply. No credit check, contract, or installation fee. Taxes, extra restrictions apply.
Now batting in the top of the fourth for the Austin Bulldogs, the pitcher Harrison Gordon.
I think I misspoke. I think I said it was the end of the fourth. It's the end of the third. Now we move to the top of the fourth. And Austin trailing Ridge Point 5-0. Harrison Golden leads off and swings at a changeup and misses as Tyler Dasher continues to work for these Panthers. Golden wants to take off the red batting gloves and put them back on, tighten up the Velcro, or actually he's going to stuff them in the pocket. He's going to bat barehanded. Dasher, always pitching from the stretch, brings it, swings and misses, does Golden, and the count 0-2. They play him to pull very slightly in the outfield, but the wind continues to blow in from center field. I don't think we're going to have any long balls tonight. There's a spiked splitter, and it's 1-2. Dasher comes set, brings the 1-2, swung on and missed. Nelson has to pick it up and tag Golden. One away here in the top of the fourth.
Now batting the right fielder,
Dugas. There you go. Strikeouts for Dasher. Ryan Dugas, lefty swinger, started to go on the first one, but it's a called strike on the inside edge. Ryan hit by a pitch to lead off the second, and here he is batting in the top of the fourth. It's 5-0, Ridgepoint. There's a line shot back up the middle. He hammered a curveball, and it just missed, hitting Dasher on the hip. And Austin with a runner on, with only one away here in the top of the fourth.
Now batting third baseman, Tyler Doe.
So you got Tyler Doe and Tyler Dasher. Dasher comes set, brings it. Breaking ball on, or actually a changeup. And he swung underneath it. Nothing in one. That pitch is a strike at the letters. And we'll see what Dasher throws on an 0-2 count. He basically spikes one, but it swung on and missed. Strikeout makes it two away, and Doe started to run to first, but it's occupied, so you can't do that. Strikeout number 5 for Dasher. And Blake Watts having a one for one night. Dugas at first base after his base hit. There's a strike to Watts on the outside corner. Dasher shakes off Nelson's first sign. Now he gets to what he wants. Hammered toward third, scooped up, firing across, and there for the out. Pfeiffer to Groen, and that'll do it. Two strikeouts in the inning for Tyler Dasher, and we'll move on to the bottom of the fourth. Ridgepoint on top of Austin, 4-0.
Fast Wi-Fi. You use it to connect just about everything, which means having really fast Wi-Fi matters a lot. That's why Xfinity is breaking the gig barrier and introducing Wi-Fi speeds faster than a gig. That's a big deal. It's a big deal for streaming big games, having big meetings, and making big plans. It's a big deal for families with one kid, or two kids, or three kids, especially if there's one kid who has enough devices for 10 kids. It's a big deal for gamers who are streaming while someone else is posting about their virtual spin class. And yet, it's also a big deal for a quiet Friday night in. So get in on Wi-Fi speeds faster than a gig. That's more than enough speed to power every device in the house. Can your internet do that? Introducing gig speeds over Wi-Fi. It's the fastest Wi-Fi you can get, and it's only from Xfinity. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit an Xfinity store to learn more. Restrictions apply. Actual speeds vary and are not guaranteed.
Colin Daigh, who started the big rally in the bottom of the third.
For Ridgepoint, a designated hitter, number 10, Colin Daigh.
He got a single. Came around to score. Actually, I think it was Tyler Martin running for him. But that led to a 5-run third inning. Ridgepoint still enjoys the 5-run advantage as the Panthers bat in the bottom of the fourth. After Daigh, it'll be Ferris and Vossis. First pitch, breaking ball is down from Harrison Golden. There's a lonely nightbird circling around above the field. Here's the 1-0. Fastball high, and Golden, he wasn't ready for DeSiga's return throw, and it went all the way past second base. And it's just a good thing it didn't hit him in the head. And Nikwan Benjamin, maybe someday when his playing days are done, he'll be an athletic trainer. He was checking on Golden to make sure he was okay. Here's the 2-0 pitch. Daigh leaves that one alone. It's down and away for ball three, and Golden upset with himself for getting behind on a leadoff hitter in a game where the Dogs already trail 5-0. Here's the pitch. That's a strike. Looked like Daigh was taking all the way. Here's the 3-1. In there for a strike, 3-1. They're in the fifth inning at George Ranch, and the Dulles Vikings are still trailing. They haven't gotten on the board. 2-0, George Ranch on top of Dulles. Daigh fouls one back. The Ridgepoint girls have scratched across another run, and they trail Tompkins 10-5 in the bottom of the fifth, or after five, I should say, in the first game of their 2-out-of-3 softball playoff series. And Daigh fouls away another one. Blaine Simmons got the RBI. Swung on and missed by Daigh. Beautiful breaking ball by Golden. One out for Owen Ferris.
Owen Ferris.
Owen's 1-for-1. First pitch to him, breaking ball, burns off the outside corner. Golden, ready to deliver again. Starts his windup, the right-hander brings it. Ferris takes one down and away for a ball. Each team with three hits, but Ridgepoint leads it 5-0. Here's the pitch. breaking ball and a beauty in there, nothing in two. Correction, one and two. Golden brings it. Hard smash off of Doe's arm. And Ferris is going to be safe. That'll be an error on third baseman Tyler Doe. Now back to the top and Justin Fossus.
Number eight, Justin Vasos.
Walked and scored in the third. We'll see if Ferris tries to move his way into scoring position. Pitch to Vasos, breaking ball, swings to the first pitch, high in the air to right center. It's hanging up, and there's going to be the catch out there by Dugas. And he gets it back in, and Ferris has to retreat to first base. Now, one of the things you do when you broadcast baseball is you have a
Kyle Rosa.
You have a flip chart that says who's fielding. Well, I flip it over each half inning, but the wind blows it where the Ridgepoint fielders were facing, and that's why I didn't say Dugas right away. With two outs and the runner still at first, that's Ferris, Kyle Rosa. Ready for the pitch, here it comes. And it's a ground ball towards second. Watts sees it bounce off of his glove. Another error and there are two men on. Ridgepoint's bats haven't been that hot, but you know, if you give a team five outs.
Now batting the center fielder, Garrett Johnson.
So Rosa safe on the E4, and now Garrett Johnson, he reached on an error in the third inning and hits a ground ball to Benjamin at short, picks it clean, fires across. It's a low throw, not caught by Sherman. Now an advance home, and Ferris scores. Benjamin picked it clean, but his throw was low. Sherman had to reach over to his right and backhand it. And it didn't stay in his glove, and Ferris kept coming around third, and
plate.
It's 6-0.
The catcher, Brandon Nelson.
I almost hate to do it, but I think that was a throwing error, so. Now Brandon Nelson comes up. Still more opportunities with two outs. And Rosa, the runner at second. That's a curveball. But it's outside. Rosa at second. Johnson at first. Golden just trying to get out of this inning. It's 6-0. Strike on the outside corner. A little run in the fastball. And the Lonely Nightbird is close to home plate now. That's outside. They do a real good job picking the music here at Ridgepoint. Do a great job at Travis, too. Maybe they'll play Stevie Nicks, you know, just like a white-winged dove, even though I don't think the bird that's flying around is indeed a white-winged dove. 2-1, swung on and fouled back into the screen, and it's 2-2. Quinn Pfeiffer comes away from the on-deck area to pick up the stray foul ball. Chopper going overhead. And Golden steps off. Rosa walks back to second. No one was covering. Golden ready. Here's the pitch. And Nelson sends a high fly ball to left field. Going back is McGoldrick, and he's got it. Runs it down, and the wind was a little bit of a help there. You know, taking care of business is what Office Depot does for us. We appreciate all their help this year. We've had a record-breaking year at VibeFortBend.com with more than 100 live broadcasted events. We'll be right back with the fifth inning. Ridge Point Panthers leading Austin 6-0.
You are the master of the multitask, the champion of making it happen. Taking care of business is not for the faint of heart. Still, you take care of it.
Taking care of business.
But who takes care of you? Office Depot Office Max. We supply you, copy you, and tune you up. Members get 2% back in rewards on everything, and we mean everything. We take care of you, so you can take care of business. Office Depot Office Max.
Taking care of business.
First Tire Automotive will shower you in savings in April. Make sure you're not caught saying the wrong S word when it starts raining because you can't see out of your windshield. Safety first to get you to and from the big game. Check out these great savings. Wiper blades, buy one, get one free. Buy one, get one free on select Contour Beam windshield wipers. Purchase four select BF Goodrich, Goodyear, General, or Uniroyal tires with a premium installation package and wheel alignment and save $100. First Tire Automotive, a proud sponsor of Fort Bend Vibe Sports. Make your appointment today at any of the four convenient locations in Sugarland and Cinco Ranch. All four stores open on Saturday. FirstTireAuto.com.
Parker Menifee is going to pinch hit.
Now batting for Austin, Bryson Williams.
Well, Parker Menifee is in the field. He's playing first base. Later, he will hit. And Bryson Williams leads off for Austin. We're in the top of the fifth, and the Bulldogs are down 6-0. They start the night with a record of 6-6 in district play, and they are 1.5 games behind the Elkins Knights, who are in the third spot right now. And they are also just percentage points, actually 1.5 game ahead of Clements, which is percentage points ahead of Dulles. So if the Dogs lose, they're back in a pickle again. First pitch from Tyler Dasher is a curveball swung on and missed. Bryson Williams struck out his first time against Dasher. Here's the pitch in the dirt, and the count is 1-1. You know, there are certain weather patterns you just wonder if they're ever going to stop, and every night we seem to have these ridiculous winds. Here's the 1-1 on the corner for a strike, the outside corner. And Bryson Williams will dig in from the right side. Dasher from the stretch tries to tempt him with a curveball, but he laid off, and it's 2-2. Dasher brings the next one. Swing and a miss. Dasher's making it look pretty easy so far. Six strikeouts. Ridge Point leads 6-0. The hits are even at 3, but Austin has made 5 errors. Ridge Point only 1. And DeSiga swings at the first pitch and fouls it back. I think it got over the backstop. Mark Sherman waits to bat next. Breaking ball. He fights it off. He fists it foul over the screen on the right. Dasher comes set, comes home with it, outside. Plays DeSiga straight away. And there's a weakly hit ground ball to Ellis at second. Picks it up and fires over to Menifee. That makes it out number 2.
Now batting first baseman, Mark Sherman.
Now Mark Sherman. ball to third. His first time up. First pitch. Swung on and missed. Dasher really with the high release point, kind of like Jim Palmer used to do on that one. Now he tries to get Sherman to chase. That one's in the dirt and it's 1-1. Sherman ready, here it comes. That's also in the dirt. By the way, I've noticed something pretty cool that Nelson does. He'll catch a pitch in the dirt and he will hand the ball, just a second. Here's the pitch, swung on and missed. He transfers the ball from his mitt to his right hand between his knees. It's kind of like, a guy who does tricks with a basketball, dribbling between his feet. 2-2 the count. Outside, and the count is full on Mark Sherman as he tries to get on with two outs in this top of the fifth inning, and he and the Austin Bulldogs trailing 6-0. Pitch on the way. He hits it high in the air. Coming in for it is Rosa, and he just gets there ahead of the shortstop Vasas, and they're smiling. They're not fighting. Okay, well, that does it for the top of the fifth. Still 6-0 Ridgepoint. A 1-2-3 inning for Tyler Dasher. We'll be back on VipeFortBend.com.
Fast Wi-Fi. You use it to connect just about everything, which means having really fast Wi-Fi matters. A lot. That's why Xfinity is breaking the gig barrier and introducing Wi-Fi speeds faster than a gig. That's a big deal. It's a big deal for streaming big games, having big meetings, and making big plans. It's a big deal for families with one kid, or two kids, or three kids. Especially if there's one kid who has enough devices for 10 kids. It's a big deal for gamers who are streaming while someone else is posting about their virtual spin class. And yet, it's also a big deal for a quiet Friday night in. So get in on Wi-Fi speeds faster than a gig. That's more than enough speed to power every device in the house. Can your internet do that? Introducing gig speeds over Wi-Fi. It's the fastest Wi-Fi you can get, and it's only from Xfinity. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit an Xfinity store to learn more. Restrictions apply. Actual speeds vary and are not guaranteed.
Ellis, Pfeiffer, and Groen coming to the plate for Ridgepoint in the bottom of the fifth. The Panthers lead it 6-0 over Austin. By the way,
for Ridgepoint, the bottom of the fifth, the second baseman, Zach Ellis.
Tyler Dasher putting together a pretty good pitching night for Ridgepoint. He's had 2 1-2-3 innings and another inning. It wasn't 1-2-3, but thanks to a double play, he faced the minimum. So he's been very economical with his pitches. He's only given up the three hits. And Ellis, first pitch swinging, high pop up on the infield, and Golden calling for it, and it squirts out of his mitt. The frustration is going to boil over soon for the Austin Bulldogs. That is error number 6. They had 3 in the previous half inning.
Now batting.
Now
the third
Quinn
baseman.
Pfeiffer.
Quinn Pfeiffer.
It makes sense for Golden to go after that because he's a third baseman. He catches pop-ups all the time, and I'm not really sure what happened there. Here's Pfeiffer. First pitch taking, and it's a ball outside. Pfeiffer has grounded out and walked. Golden looked like he was ready, but he stepped off, and Ellis walks back to the bag at first. Pfeiffer's ready. Here's Golden's pitch. Breaking ball outside. Austin has Elkins Friday, and then their season is done. Swung on by Pfeiffer and fouled straight back. One on the way, high, and it's 3-1. Good to see Michael Dutka in the first base coaching box for Ridgepoint. 3-1, and it's outside. Pfeiffer is on board with a walk. The reason I say it's really good to see Michael Dutka, well, first of all, when would it not be good to see Michael Dutka? But he got hit in the face with a baseball and did some damage. He's not nearly as good looking as he normally is right now, but he will recover fully. Now we have Jim Tucker coming out of the Austin dugout, takes the baseball from Harrison Golden, who will go to third base. And it looks like the new pitcher will come in from left field. That'll be Matthew McGoldrick. Tyler Doe will go out to left field and play there. We'll take a break and be back and tell you about Matthew McGoldrick when we return on VibeFortBend.com. Ridgepoint still batting in the bottom of the fifth and leading 6-0. Wild Thing, that's kind of tough. Come on now.
I have a question.
Are you ready? Ready for anything? Ready for what life throws at you? At your kids?
Are they ready to study? To research? To write papers?
To do all the amazing things they don't even know they're capable of yet? And what about you? Yeah, you! Are you ready?
Are you ready?
Are you ready? Ready to take opportunity?
To make opportunity?
To be on top of things?
Internet Essentials from Comcast brings affordable, high-speed internet to your home for only $9.95 a month. Now available to low-income households eligible for public assistance programs like Medicaid, the National School Lunch Program, SNAP, housing assistance, and others. When you're connected, you're ready for anything.
It's a simple question.
Are you ready?
Are you ready?
Ready for anything.
Visit InternetEssentials.com to apply. No credit check, contract, or installation fee. Taxes extra. Restrictions apply.
All right, Matthew McGoldrick going to be making his ninth pitching appearance and his sixth out of the bullpen. Correction, sorry about that. I'm looking in the wrong column. He's actually making his fifth pitching appearance and all of those out of the bullpen. He's thrown 9 innings thus far this year with a record of 0-1. Correction, 1-0. I'm really messing this up. Matthew McGoldrick is 1-0. This is his fifth appearance. He's thrown 9 innings, given up 8 hits, 4 runs, all of those earned. He's walked 4 and struck out 5.
Austin, now pitching, Matthew McGoldrick.
ERA of 3.11 and a whip of 1.33, and he will face Parker Menifee, batting tonight for the first time for the Panthers. Menifee, big, tall, right-handed hitter. Tight end on the football team facing Matthew McGoldrick, who brings it. First pitch is down and in for a ball. McGoldrick, a left-hander. Inherits a tough situation, already down 6-0. Nobody out and runners at first and second. And Menifee looks at a curveball in there for a strike. The changes, Golden to third base, Doe to left field, and McGoldrick on the mound. Comes set, the left-hander brings it. Menifee hits a bouncer, past second base and into right field. Around third and coming home is Ellis. That makes it 7-0. And Pfeiffer stays at third base. Point just keeps stretching the lead out.
For Ridge Point, the designated hitter, Colin Daigh.
Now Colin Daigh, the DH. He's 1-for-2. So when we finish this one up, we'll kind of let you know about the reset of the standings that will occur tonight as McGoldrick brings that first pitch today outside for ball one. Ridge Point scored a run in the seventh, but they trail 13-5 to Tompkins. There's a ball on the second pitch to Colin Daigh. Down and in, gets away from DeSiga, but no move by either of the base runners. Menifee is at first, and Pfeiffer is at third base. Still nobody out in the Ridge Point sixth. And you know, if they tack on three more runs, we'll go on home. Here's the pitch. High to Daigh, and that is ball four. Bases are loaded. Menifee moves to second. Pfeiffer still at third.
Batting the right fielder, Owen Ferris.
And no place to put Owen Ferris. McGoldrick comes set, brings it. That is fouled back, and look out. Not a car, it was the top of the hitting facility they have in Ridge Point. Here's the 0-1 from McGoldrick. Started to pull the trigger, but Ferris held off and it was high for a ball. McGoldrick at the belt. Here he comes. That is fouled straight back. Ridge Point with 7 runs, but only on 4 hits. 6 errors by Austin. McGoldrick brings it. That is down the left field line, hooking, and it will go foul. And Doe made a really good run at that one, never giving up. Sometimes hard to know what to do when the wind is blowing so strong in from straightaway center. Here's the 1-2, and Ferris takes it outside the count, even 2-2. Goldrick leans in, bends at the waist, gets the sign he wants, brings it. Ferris swings and fouls it out of play to the right, still 2-2. We're still considering coverage tomorrow night as the Austin Bulldog girls take on the Katy Tigers in the first round of the softball playoffs. Game one will be at peaceful, bucolic Pheasant Creek. Pitch gets underneath DeSiga, and Pfeiffer scores to make it 8-0. That was ball three, and that'll be a passed ball. And Ridge Point is 2 runs away from the high school baseball version of a technical knockout. Now there are runners at second and third. Here's the pitch. That's outside. Ferris walks, and the bases are loaded again. Menifee at third, Daig at second, and Ferris at first. And now Justin Vasos.
Shortstop, Justin Vasos.
See what Justin can do here. First pitch to him is a ball. Goldick brings the next one. That is high in the air to center field, ranging over his branch. It's drifting over into right field where the catch is made by Dugas. Coming on home from third is Menifee, and it's a sacrifice fly to make it 9-0 as Vasos gets the job done. Second sacrifice fly tonight for the Ridgepoint Panthers.
Now batting for Ridgepoint, the left fielder, Kyle Rosa.
The other sacrifice fly belonged to Brandon Nelson. And now Kyle Rosa, just needing to drive home one more run to put this one to bed early. McGoldrick brings it. Rosa hits a fly ball to Branch in center. There's no one at third now. He actually throws back to second to try and double off Daig, but Daig gets back. And now there are two outs. And if this game is going to be over after five innings, it's going to be up to Garrett Johnson.
Garrett Johnson.
The quote-unquote winning run is at second base in the person of Colin Daig. And here's Garrett Johnson facing McGoldrick. For the first time, the lefty brings it. Curveball on the outside corner. McGoldrick, definitely a finesse pitcher. He likes to make that release point over on the first base side, so the ball comes in at a tough angle. Here's the 0-1. That's a strike on the inside corner to Johnson. He'll be protecting. The 0-2 on the way. And he fouls it back. Johnson battling. Daig would like to scurry home with run number 10. Here's the pitch. That's to center field. Branch came in. Now he goes back and makes the catch. And Ridgepoint leads 9-0, but that means we're going to play at least one more inning. We'll be back with more. Top of the sixth. Panthers in control, 9-0 over Austin on VipeFortBend.com.
Fast Wi-Fi. You use it to connect just about everything, which means having really fast Wi-Fi matters a lot. That's why Xfinity is breaking the gig barrier and introducing Wi-Fi speeds faster than a gig. That's a big deal. It's a big deal for streaming big games, having big meetings, and making big plans. It's a big deal for families with one kid, or two kids, or three kids, especially if there's one kid who has enough devices for 10 kids. It's a big deal for gamers who are streaming while someone else is posting about their virtual spin class. And yet, it's also a big deal for a quiet Friday night in. So get in on Wi-Fi speeds faster than a gig. That's more than enough speed to power every device in the house. Can your internet do that? Introducing gig speeds over Wi-Fi. It's the fastest Wi-Fi you can get, and it's only from Xfinity. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit an Xfinity store to learn more. Restrictions apply. Actual speeds vary and are not guaranteed.
I guess that's the 21st century version of the Cotton Eye Joe. And you know, since it's a 9-0 game, I thought I'd bring up a few random things.
Now playing right field, number 15, Mason Dossett.
Mason Dossett now in right field for the Panthers. And top of the order,
for
Ryan Branch.
Ryan Branch.
So how many of these players have last names that are also those of musical artists? And you get bonus points if it's a one-hit wonder. First pitch to Ryan Branch. Boy, the table dropped. Actually, that one dropped off the table. Tyler Dasher still pitching masterfully. And it's nothing and one on Branch. Second pitch burns off the outside edge and beautifully located by Dasher. And before Ryan Branch looks at the next pitch, I have to say I really enjoyed the music of Michelle Branch back around 2005, 2006, 2007 maybe. Swung on and missed it, a pitch in the dirt. Nelson picks it up, fires down to Menifee, completing the putout. Well, Dulles taking it on the chin at George Ranch. They're down 6-0 in the sixth. Now it's Naquan Benjamin, 0-2, hit into a double play in the third. That was a real rally killer. Momentum has just never been on the side of the Bulldogs this evening. Takes the first pitch outside for ball one. Dasher comes set. Benjamin looks at one down and away. So Austin is going to lose this game. Dulles is also losing. And so here's the pitch. That is sliced down the right field line, but it's foul. So with Dulles down at George Ranch and Austin trailing 9-0 here, the Clements Rangers are the team that benefits. Clements is 6-7 in district play, and Austin will be in a flat-footed tie with the Rangers after tonight. Dulles will fall to 5-7 and will be a half game behind both Clements and Austin. 2-1 to Benjamin. Fouled in the air and out of our sight to the right. Brandon Nelson looks over at the dugout. Tyler Dasher waits patiently. Gets the sign he wants. Here comes the 2-2 to Benjamin. Swung on and missed. Tyler Dasher throwing a masterpiece.
Harrison
Golden, and both of these teams played last night, but Ridge Point's been the one playing with a spring in their step. Harrison Golden trying to get Austin on the board. That pitch goes way wide and all the way to the backstop. 1-0 on Harrison. Crowds the plate from the right-handed box. The 1-0 just missed the outside corner. Golden is ready and brings it. And there's a smash base hit. Hard to the left side and into left field for a single. And Kyle Rosa gets it into Vosses, who gets it to Ellis. And with two outs, there's a runner on for the Dogs, and now Ryan Dugas will come up.
Adding the right fielder, Ryan Dugas.
That's just the fourth hit that Dasher has allowed. Left-handed swinging, Ryan Dugas. Ready for the first one. Takes one over but low. Ball one. Nine to nothing Ridge Point as Austin bats in the bottom or the top of the sixth. There's a pitch that kind of looked like the first one, but it was called a strike at the knees. Next pitch is way high. By the way, Parker Menifee at first base is not holding Golden on to the, not over there ready to take a pickoff throw. 2-1 on the way. Dugas comes up empty on the big swing. And the count even 2-2. Chokes up slightly on the bat and hits it high in the air, foul ground on the left side. There goes Pfeiffer into foul ground, and he overran it, and it fell to earth. It's a tricky wind, there's no doubt about it. So Dugas lives to swing at least one more pitch if he wants. Now he stands in again, bouncing a little bit. Here's Dasher's pitch. Swung on and he just got a piece of it. Nicked it and it trickled back to the backstop. His teammates still encouraging, say, way to battle. They're down 9-0. Can't really do anything about it now except do some things right as you finish this one up. Here's the pitch from Dasher upstairs and the count goes full. So with two outs and Golden at first, he'll get a head start with the next pitch to Dugas. Dyler comes set, a Dasher comes set, brings it, and that's ball four high. Dugas works a walk. Now Tyler Doe, who's 0-2 with a pair of swinging strikeouts. Doe now playing left field for Austin. Here's the pitch from Dasher in there for a strike. Wind continuing to blow in. I can't wait till it stops. Swung on and missed. Pulled the string on the breaking ball. On and fouled off to the right. Oh, and to the count. Here it comes to Tyler Doe. And it's a ground ball to second. Ellis has it, flips to Vasas at second, and that forces the final out of the inning. And Rich Point will come up to bat in the bottom of the sixth, and one more run will end this game. We'll be right back on FightFortBend.com.
First Tire Automotive will shower you in savings in April. Make sure you're not caught saying the wrong S word when it starts raining because you can't see out of your windshield. Safety first to get you to and from the big game. Check out these great savings. Wiper blades, buy one, get one free. Buy one, get one free on select contour beam windshield wipers. Purchase four select BF Goodrich, Goodyear, General, or Uniroyal tires with a premium installation package and wheel alignment and save $100. First Tire Automotive, a proud sponsor of Fort Bend Vipe Sports. Make your appointment today at any of the four convenient locations in Sugar Land and Cinco Ranch. All four stores open on Saturday. FirstTireAndAuto.com.
Welcome back. Ridge Point trying to finish this one off. Matthew McGoldrick, the left-hander, still out there for the Dogs. Ridge Point will send up Brandon Nelson, Zach Ellis, and Quinn Pfeiffer, at least those are the hitters who are due. Good, consistent offensive attack for Ridgepoint. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different players have scored runs for the Ridgepoint Panthers. Runs in the third.
5-6 for Ridgepoint. The catcher, Brandon Nelson.
5 runs in the third, 1 in the fourth, 3 in the sixth. I'm sorry. Hold on. Nelson swings the first pitch and he fouled it off his foot. He's going to be okay. It was 5 runs in the third, 1 in the fourth, and 3 in the fifth. And that's how we got to 9-0. And Ridgepoint will try to run rule Austin. Winner of Tyler Dasher, and with so many games to play, making up for the COVID quarantine, Ridgepoint can use a complete game from their starter. And Nelson with a hot smash past Michael Dutka in the first base coaching box. He hops out of the way, and I think we can understand his desperation to get out of the way of any baseball coming his way with any direction, any velocity. Here's the 0-2. And there's another foul ball over near first. Coach Dutka avoids it. Like to say hi to his little son, Landon, who was my buddy during the 2019 playoffs. 0-2 to Nelson. And that hit him. He's on. So Landon Dutka, I guess at the time maybe he was 5. I'm not really sure how old he is right now, but he would color. He had this coloring book for the Paw Patrol, and he'd give me these colored drawings of the Paw Patrol.
Now batting for Ridgepoint, number 20, Joe Richard.
And I put them up on the wall in the broadcast booth at the University of Houston, where the Panthers defeated Kingwood in the playoffs. Okay, Joe Richard is batting, comes off the bench for Ridgepoint, and he powers one to left center field. That is deep, but it'll hang up in the wind, and the catch made by Doe, he gets it back in. Yep.
Your attention please for Ridgepoint, now running in first base, number 22, Blaine Ryan.
Yes, I was going to check on that. Blaine Ryan is running at first.
Number 30, Aiden Dineen.
I want to meet Aiden's family and ask them if he is any relation to a guy named Bill Dineen, who used to be the coach of the Houston Aeros hockey team back when Gordie Howe and his sons Mark and Marty were on the team. First pitch to Dineen is outside. Dineen, right-handed hitter. Pitch, and that's outside, actually catches the outside corner. Strike 2 on Dineen. Blaine Ryan running at first with one out, Ridgepoint leading 9-0 in the bottom of the sixth. Here's the pitch to Dineen, and he powers one to center field. It will drop in front of Ryan Branch. Two men on for Ridgepoint with one away. Nice swing by Dineen.
Now batting the first baseman, Parker Menifee.
Now Parker Menifee with a chance to drive home the game-ending run. Will Ryan flow home? Will the Ryan flow home? High in the air, and it's going to go out of play. Will it hit the bleachers? Look out. Actually, it hits concrete, and everybody's okay. Menifee steps in. Big, tall kid. Matthew McGoldrick, not so tall. The left-hander brings it down and in. Gets away from DeSiga, but he make sure that the base runners do not move. Rhine remains at second, and Dineen remains at first. Menifee going to do what he can to end this ball game. And that's a smash to third base. Golden is going to run the runner back and tag him. And step on second. Dineen forgot to run, and it's a double play. Oh, boy. We're going to play at least one more half inning. All right. 9-0 Ridge Point. We'll be back. Okay, my commercial thing is not working anymore, so we don't need to take another commercial break. I just want to make sure you understand what happened there. So we had Blaine Rhine at second base, and he started running toward third on the ground ball to Harrison Golden, who is playing third base. And Golden, instead of stepping on the bag, decided to run Rhine back to second. Meanwhile, Dineen just did not run. Aiden Dineen didn't run from first to second, even though it was a ground ball. So I think Tyler Dasher was looking forward to not going back out there. But now he has to throw one more inning. Okay, so musical artists who have the same last names as players in this game. You got Garrett Johnson. You know, Tom Johnson was the original lead vocalist for the Doobie Brothers. Well,
your attention, please, for Ridge Point. Now pitching number 7, Hunter Nichols.
Okay, Hunter Nichols is coming in. You know, the 7 looked like a 2, and I thought Dasher was still out there, but Dasher's night is done, and I'm sure he would have loved to have pitched a complete game of 6 innings, but Hunter Nichols comes on to try and finish it off, and the first man he's going to face is Blake Watts. Here's the pitch. Strike at the letters. Night for some people we love in the baseball and softball world. Next pitch is a strike to Blake Watts. Tompkins beat the Ridge Point girls 15-5 in game 1 of their softball playoff series as Watts fouls one back. So they'll play games 2 and 3 hopefully at Tompkins on Friday. George Ranch in the 6th, leading the Dulles Vikings 8-0. Hunter Nichols brings the 0-2 curveball, and Watts just got a piece and fouled it back. Right-handed hitting Watts, looking at Nichols for the first time, and the home plate umpire says, wait. Now, Eros DeSiga, who came to pick up the foul ball, is back in the dugout. And the pitch is outside, 1-2 now to Watts. Nichols doesn't want to mess around. He's ready to plow right now. Here comes the pitch. Ground ball to third. Scoop, a bobble, and a late throw. And Blake Watts is on. For Ridge Point, that is error number 2. And Quinn Pfeiffer didn't catch it clean. And that's one of those examples. When you play baseball, the dimensions of the field are so perfect because if you field it cleanly, get rid of it, and throw accurately, you'll almost always get the guy out. But the bobble was just enough to get Watts on. So through no fault of his own, Hunter Nichols pitching with a man aboard at first base. And for the Bulldogs, this is Osmont. He's coming off the bench. Curveball high to Osmont, and it's 1-1. Nelson with a sign for Nichols. Pitch to Osmont, swung on and missed, and it's 1-2. So Hunter Nichols is the Panthers' save specialist, but this is not a save situation with the Panthers up 9-0. Pitch on the way. Osmont takes high and outside. 2-1 the count. Ridge Point doesn't have to play again until Friday night when they'll host Travis. But then they have another game with Dulles to finish it off on Saturday. 2-2 swung on and missed, and down goes Osmont. That's the first out here in the seventh. DeSiga up to bat for these Austin Bulldogs. Nothing. Ridge Point on top, just trying to finish it off. Blake Watts leads off first base. Pitch to DeSiga. Outside for a ball.
Now batting for Austin, DeSiga.
Want to know the count. Nichols comes set, comes home. Outside. Nelson backhands it. The 2-0 count on DeSiga. At first, now comes home with it, swung on and missed, and the count 2-1. Here's the pitch, breaking ball, and it gets away from Nelson, and Watts is going to take second. There's the throw. It's a good one, but it's just a little late. Turned around and tried to put a tag on Watts, but he was already there. And the count 3-1 on DeSiga. Nichols goes through several signs before he gets the one he wants. Now here it comes. Adds a chopper toward first base, but it is Ellis going to throw to Menifee. That's an out. And on the play, Watts moves over to third. Two down.
Now
and Mark Sherman will bat.
Mark Sherman.
Here's the pitch to Sherman. Strike on the outside corner. Nichols comes set, comes home with it. Breaking ball, but it's high. Nichols brings the 1-1. Fouled back, and now the Bulldogs are down to their final strike. But Nikwan Benjamin's got to come get the foul ball. The pitch to Sherman in the dirt. He takes. Watts stays at third because Sherman puts up the hand. Nichols brings it. Just off the outside corner in the count now 3-2. Sherman ready. Nichols kicks and comes home. And it's down the right field line and twisting into the Ridge Point bullpen. Actually over the bullpen. Dossett gives it a look over there. Okay. You know, this game is only a little over 2 hours old. Here's the pitch. There's a ground ball to Vosses at short. Grabs it with two hands and fires in time. There's your final out, and Ridgepoint wins it 9-0. So we'll be back with the totals for you here on VipeFortBend.com. Okay, well, the commercial thing's not. All right, sorry you had to listen to silence there. I didn't mean for it to go silent. Anyway, here are your totals on tonight's game. For the Austin Bulldogs, no runs on four hits, and they made six errors. It was just a very, very tough night in the field for the Bulldogs. For the winning Ridgepoint Panthers, 9 runs on 5 hits, and they made 2 errors themselves. You only out-hit the opposition 5-4, but you win the game 9-0. That's one of those little oddities of baseball. Tyler Dasher doesn't get the complete game. His team couldn't quite run rule the Bulldogs, but he does get the win, and Hunter Nichols pitches the final inning to finish it off, and Harrison Golden takes the loss for the Bulldogs. The time of the game, 2 hours and 5 minutes. And let's... the coach's wife needs to get her the thing that has secured my umbrella. Thank you, Ms. Welch. I really appreciate it. Okay. Yes, but then I'd have to bring scissors. Okay, so I'm making new friends all over the place. All right, so here are the standings, the up-to-the-minute standing. So the Travis Tigers weren't playing tonight, but they wrapped up the District 26A title last night anyway. They have a record of 12-1. Ridgepoint improves to 9-3. Elkins, idle tonight, is still 8-5. So Ridgepoint now moves a game and a half ahead of Elkins, and they're 2 games up in the loss column. So Ridgepoint is probably in pretty solidly as the second seed out of District 26A. Elkins probably pretty solidly in as the third seed with a record of 8-5. So Austin falls to 6-7. Clements is also 6-7. So those two teams are tied for the fourth spot. And you know, if the season ends with Austin and Clements tied, or Austin and Dulles tied, or any combination of those, then somebody's going to have to play an extra game prior to the playoffs. Dulles tonight loses at George Ranch, and their record falls to 5-7. So Clements, idle, stays 6-7. Austin drops to 6-7, and Dulles falls to 5-7. And Dulles still has George Ranch at home Friday, and then they will come here to Ridgepoint on Saturday. Clements has a Friday game against Bush, but we expect them to win that and that they would improve to 6-7. And Austin is at Elkins Friday. So if Clements holds serve at Bush and gets their win there and Austin falls to Elkins, then Clements would be the fourth playoff seed outright. So what else can I tell you? Well, I can tell you that the Ridgepoint girls lost to Tompkins 15-5 in game one of their softball playoff series this evening. And that series will move to Tompkins for games two and hopefully game three on Friday night. So we will let you know if we're going to do a game tomorrow. Softball girls from Austin are going to be taking on the favored Katy Tigers, but you know, that's why they play the game, right? Game one will be at peaceful bucolic Pheasant Creek, and we'll see if we can bring that one to you. For everybody on the Vibe team, this is Roger Smith saying so long. I want to say thank you very much to Ms. Jenny Welch for lending me something to help secure our umbrella so you didn't have to listen to the wind so much. I want to thank Clary Groen, the PA announcer here at Ridgepoint. And I want to thank our producer, Suna Venkat, for helping us monitor the quality and maintain our signal. Again, our final score, a rather forgettable game, 9-0. Ridgepoint wins over the Austin Bulldogs. And we will say so long for right now, but we know that we'll be joining you at a ballpark soon as VibeFortBend.com is your broadcast home for Fort Bend County sports. Good night, everybody.